Today we're gonna have like a little intro session de la besada sister porque we realized que although everybody knows that Pia is my big sister, like who are we and why are we here chismeando como unas locas? And we've gotten a lot of questions como que ¿quién es la mayor? ¿Ustedes de dónde son? Whatever, whatever, whatever. ¿Por qué le dicen Pia? Pia, is that her name?
Oh my God, yes, I get that a lot still.
Okay, so we're here to talk about, y después como que también vamos a hacer como que un poquito de who we are, así como who's most likely to, which I think is super fun.
Yes.
Between sisters.
Yes.
Okay, so lo primero, what are you obsessed with this week?
Oh my God, I knew you were going to ask me that. And this week has been kind of like blur. Completely, but I did like an age, so my best friend from forever is here, and I did a little like Asian, she loves Asian food, so in Houston there's like a little Chinatown, it's not little, it's a big Chinatown, and it's really authentic like Asian food. So I have, you ever seen those cheesecakes, the viral cheesecakes where they shake? They're so fluffy.
Yeah.
So they have them here in Houston. It's called Nico's Cheesecake.
Okay. Was it to die?
Holy. So good.
Oh.
So, okay. It's
so
like
jelly.
You imagine, como que, I don't even know how to describe it, porque Julián and Joe were trying to describe how it is, porque es como, you think cheesecake and you think like thick and hearty and like, you know, like, condensed. Esto es como, imagine like you're eating like the same thing as like, you know how cotton candy kind of se derrite en tu boca? Kind of like that. It's almost like so airy and fluffy and it's not super sweet, so it's not overpowering. It's so good. So,
oh, I'm into
cheesecake.
This.
Japanese cheesecake. So good.
I'm super into this, by the way.
Yes.
It's a good obsession.
Yes.
I'm obsessed with two things.
Okay.
One of them is my new dry shampoo.
Oh, the K18?
Oh, my God.
I know. I've heard so much about it, but if it's a price tag, it's not happy.
No, mami, it's sold out everywhere.
I know.
It's sold out everywhere. I was able to find it at a local beauty supply. Donde yo me hago el pelo, le llegó, and I told the owner, I'm like, you better save me one or no te voy a hablar más. Like, literalmente. Pero en verdad, ¿qué diferencia?
Porque a mí el dry shampoo makes my scalp como que super itchy, me irrita,
yes.
Me irrita aquí full. So, I wanted to try it porque it's like a foam.
No. Es un spray, como si te estuviera spraying agua en el pelo. So
okay.
El pelo se le pone casi como mojado.
Okay.
And then you start like, te empiezas a hacer así, no me lo quiero hacer porque me acabo de hacer el pelo, pero you start going like that and you brush it out y holy moly macaroni. Se va el oil, no se siente crunchy, no está blanco.
Crunchy, está blanco. Okay.
Lo que sí... What I did was before I used it, porque yo, I'm obsessed with dry shampoo. Yo, don't judge
sí,
me. Yo me
are.
Lavo el pelo una vez a la semana. Because I'm a beauty, a hair salon blonde. And I have very little hair. Like, yo tengo tres mechas.
Tres mechas.
I decided to be a blonde con tres mechas. So, si yo me lavo el pelo todos los días o, like, mucho, like, me voy a quedar sin... el poquito pelo que tengo, right?
Las tres mechas de pelo.
So, I live off dry shampoo porque tampoco me gusta estar, like, el pelo sucio, que asco. Pero yo soy de las que... So, I didn't want to... Like, I quería saber bien cómo hacerlo. So, I looked at a bunch of social media de cómo hacerlo y lo hice and on the first try me salió. I did a video of it and todo, pero no lo he puesto en ningún lugar. Pero I'm going to share it porque a lot of people me preguntó sobre eso. So that's the one thing that if you can get your hands on it, it's worth it.
Porque está sold out, porque as of last week, when someone posted it, who posted it? I want to say it was Things I Liked and I Bought. Okay. Things I bought and I liked. I want to say she posted it. And I was like, that's when I looked it up. I was like, I have it in my card because it was Sephora sale. So I was like, I have it in my card. Pero the price tag, I was like, but I haven't checked to see. But it was still on.
Sephora so sold out. It sold out in Sephora.
Wow.
Yeah. It sold out
Sephora
everywhere.
Sephora sale was pretty good, so.
It's worth the money. You use a lot less product porque you only do.
Okay.
And then por secciones es nada más un spray.
Okay.
So, I mean, it's worth it. I really, really love it. If you can get your hands on it, don't think about it twice. Like, absolutely, yes, absolutely. Y huele riquísimo. Todos los productos de K18 son lo mejor del mundo, en verdad. They're sí, at a higher price point, pero they're worth, I feel that they're worth the money.
Okay.
For sure. And then the second thing that I'm obsessed with, and this is a little bit, you know, it's PGC Central, but I talk a lot about the power of personalized jewelry.
Yes.
But hay veces que la gente no entiende la capacidad de lo que eso significa.
Sí.
Okay. Una amiga mía, it took me aback, that's why I'm going to share. Una amiga mía cumplió años ahorita. And she's pregnant with her first child. Pero she's very early on, como, no sé, tiene como 4 o 5 meses, no más de eso. And she had told me that she was going to have a, she's going to have a baby boy and their name, the name of the baby starts with an M. So when it was her birthday, yo le llevé un detallito y de detallito le llevé un necklace que tenía colgándole un muñequito de un niño y una eléctrica chiquita y una M. Y se lo entrego y de repente, I don't know why I'm crying. And I'm like, porque se lo entregué y le dije feliz cumpleaños, whatever. Y fui a saludar al resto de la gente. And all of a sudden she's like, Lina, I don't know why I'm crying. And I'm like, me vuelve, I'm like, are you okay? She's like, I don't know porque me puse tan sentimental of seeing that letter and knowing como que my child's name is going to be, yes, I don't want to share them because I don't know if everybody knows her, pero como que no me gusta compartir los nombres de los niños si no tengo permiso de las mamás.
No más te ha dicho. Me dice.
Ajá.
Okay.
And she's like, tú no entiendes, no sé por qué me llenó tanto de emoción, like, no sé, I don't know, is it because of my homework? I'm like, no, because en verdad, it makes it really real, like that, like, tu cosita que te está creciendo acá adentro, it's a little person that's coming to this earth. Y obviamente ella lloró, yo lloré, lloramos todos.
Obviamente.
Me voy a poner a llorar. Like, literalmente, me recuerdo, me voy a poner, fue la semana pasada. So that's my little plug de PGC jewelry. Pero en verdad, personalized jewelry is really, de verdad,
bueno,
tiene
pero
un
es que personal
poder emocional
jewelry
grande.
It shows that you took the time to actually think this through. You took the time to select it. You took the time to do it. It's not like I bought something that was it. Like, you have to think about, like, the person. But in el caso de esta, the sex of the baby, the name of the baby. You took it into all of that. So you really, couple of things. You listened to her when she said what she was having. You know that it's her first. So there's a lot of components to personalized jewelry. So definitely, I like personalized jewelry, y a mí me gusta regalar cosas that are meaningful to that person. So
I think it's something from our mom, ¿sabes? Porque yo también, a mí me gusta hacer el regalo, que a lo mejor it's not the most expensive one or whatever, pero que sea regalo that I know that is going to be used, liked. Like, a mí me encanta regalar regalos que sean así como bien,
sí,
like,
yes,
especiales.
Sí, agreed.
So esas son las dos cosas que I'm obsessed with. Y ahora ya hablamos bastante. Let's go into the good thing, like into the achievement of us.
Yes.
Okay. I feel that a lot of people know, pero como que, like, let's talk about you first.
Okay. What do you want?
Okay.
I'm a 42-year-old Pisces.
Which is your rising cosa, ¿cuál es que
es? My name is Diana. I am a 42-year-old Pisces with an ascendant in Aries.
And what's your anagram? What's your anagram?
I am an anagram 1.
100% yes.
Que corresponde mucho with my Aries side. I'm a Pisces. So I'm an Enneagram one. I like coffee in the mornings. I drink
hot or
lots
cold
of
coffee.
Water. Yes. No,
hot or
hot.
Cold. Okay.
Hot. I like hot coffee. I am a dog parent. I work in clinical research for Alzheimer's patients, which is some people are like, oh, like all of a sudden they, I feel like then they realize that I'm smart. So then they're like, oh, it's really important what you do. And I'm like, yeah. And then I have two 25-year-olds, and then people like se ponen locos when I said that. And I do it. Sometimes I do it just for shock value. Pero I have two 25-year-olds. We are a blended family. One's his, one's mine. And then we have our baby girl, que es Emma, and she's 12.
Uh-huh.
I am born and raised in Barranquilla, Colombia.
Ooh, la arenosa.
La arenosa. Quillita, la puerta de oro de Colombia. I've lived in Puerto Rico. That's where my love de reggaeton empezó. Puerto Rico, Florida, I lived in like North Miami, and then Boca, and then Boynton Beach, and now I'm in Houston, Texas.
Y'all,
I'm fully embracing my Texan side. I love like the landscape of Texas. I love the hilly country. I love the manners. People here are so like very true Southern manners. I love that. So yeah, that is me in a nutshell. I am very passionate with the things that I love. I like having meaningful, passionate conversations with people. I look like an introvert sometimes when you first meet me, but I can also be very extroverted. Like I can also be like the life of the party and like be funny and like that kind of thing. But I have to feel safe and comfortable to do that. I can't do it just because.
Tienes que caer bien.
Y not only that, as I told you, I'm very big on energy. So it has to be like, I have to feel like you are meaningful in my life.
Claro.
I love to cook, but I hate to cook. So like, I like to cook porque I'm a foodie. I love food. People like eat to live. I live to eat.
Una empanadita, un dedito, un sushi.
Like, I really, so non-discriminatory cuando llega con food. I love it. My weakness 100% va a ser y siempre será French fries. I am a French fry connoisseur.
Yes. Ella tiene un necklace que tiene un French fry charm.
Literal, un French fry fried. In my nena necklace, I have a French fry. Yes. My husband is 10 years older than I am. So that is quite a... It's funny porque we were just talking about it, and our first son turned 25 in March 26th. And I said, well, welcome to, you know, quarter of a century. I was 25 when I met your dad. And he goes, wow. And he was 35. Good for him. I'm like,
now that you put it that way.
I was like, why are you like this? Why are you like, so this is the kind of stuff I deal with. I am a Swiftie. Gracias a my 12-year-old.
Oh, yes.
I am a full-blown Swiftie. I am so ready for Friday. She's killing me. Like, she's killing all of us. She's slowly killing us with this Friday thing. I love to read, and I really love reality TV. Like, I want to say that I feel like my work is so smart, and I'm always talking about sponsors and pharmaceuticals and protocols and all of these things. Y cuando I finally get in bed, my husband dice que that everything that you learned, your brain is turning to mush right now just by watching that. I don't care. I love me a summer house. I love me a real house. I have my Vanderpump Rules. Like,
Did you start watching the new show de Lisa Vanderpump que se llama Vanderpump Villa?
No, I haven't. I haven't it's on good. My queue porque estaba viéndome The Lucky Ones or We Are the Lucky Ones in Hulu.
Oh, sí. I watched 3 episodes and I'm waiting for a couple to acumularse.
I should have done that.
Because yeah. I really wanna, like, como los primeros 3 me los vi de seguido, like, I feel que si me veo uno me voy a quedar, like, I so know. I'd rather wait a little bit, tener unos más y ver más.
Y ver
it's very, very good. Very, it's very good.
I love it. So that's, sí, that's me. I have, ¿qué más te puedo decir? I have, you know, I've had, my best friend has been my best friend since we were little. We've been best friends.
Pero little, like, pre-K.
Preschool. Yes. So, and all the way up until now, adulthood, she is the password in all of my devices. Now people are going to start hacking me. Well, her nickname is. There's variations to it. So people don't start getting into my bank account. It's not the one in my life. She, pero es funny, porque cuando Samir, like, re-met her, she's like, oh, you're control all of the devices in my house. So it's funny. I have a dog that's a pug and I love him and he's my baby. He's probably my favorite child out of all of them. they all know it. Ellos lo saben.
Pig dog loaf of bread.
Él es un pig dog loaf of bread. He's snoring probably. Él le gusta meterse debajo de mi silla when I'm working. So when I push myself, siempre por terminar, like, hurt or something, porque I don't see that he's there. So I have to be very careful when I'm pushing my chair up, porque él siempre está underneath my seat.
Qué risa.
Yes. And I actually, funny story. So I met my husband, like, through a friend, and people don't know this a lot, pero I met him while he was married. And don't come at me, I'm not a homewrecker. Pero I met him when he was married. And it was one of those things that we met coincidentally. The kids were the same age. They were about 7 or 8 or 6 or 7. They were just turned 7. Or Carlos Alberto hadn't turned 7, Samirita had turned 7. And I met them through a friend. And we kind of, you know, talked. A friend was there. She was like, oh, a friend of mine is coming. At that point, he was married. I was like, okay, married. He was good looking. I was like, okay, fine. But he went his way. I went my way. Months later, never gave him another thought. Months later, we reconnected at this friend's baby shower. And he's like, oh, tú eres Diana. Yo conocí. Oh, my. And then he says, my son still talks about your son. That was a lie, porque era mentira. It was just a hook. And from then we started dating, and then the rest.
Pero explica que he had gotten divorced in the interim.
Oh, yes, so in the interim. So months.
We don't like cheaters here.
Cheater. During those months that we were apart, he had gotten divorced, and I was single as a bird. By the way, single Pia was really fun.
Oh my god! Yeah.
Single Pia was super fun. I mean, married Pia is just as fun, pero single Pia was super fun.
Yeah.
And I had pockets of being single porque I'm a relationship kind of girl. So I had pockets of being single. But when I had those pockets, they were super fantastic. Pero single Pia was fun, having the best time of her life. And so then I re-met him again, basically. But at that point, we were both single. And at first, I was a little, obviously, porque this man had just gotten divorced. And I'm like, this man, like, come on. Like,
he just got divorced. Go heal, guy.
Go, like, to therapy. Go, like, you know, sage the house. Like, haz algo. Pero he persisted. Y, like, we finally, like, ya, en serio, became a couple. And then the rest is history. We've been together ever since.
How many years?
So we've been married. This year is going to be 13. But we've been together since, so we count the togetherness is, we counted on the date of our first date. So our first date technically was 2007, but we really didn't make it official 2008. Pero, so 2008 es que, 15? No. 2008 es que?
16.
16? So 16 years together. So,
Jesus.
I know. It feels, sometimes it feels longer, not in a bad way, pero porque I feel like I've known him so much and I feel like he knows me so much. Es como que, pero by the way, he is a mystery box. So every time he's 10 years older than me. So every time we talk about something, he's like, yo alguna vez te conté that I did this. And I'm like, no,
what did this happen?
This weird like stories randomly. So I'm like, you had never told me this.
Never heard this.
Never heard this before. So él siempre dice, sí, there's always, I can always surprise you with something.
Oh.
So I feel like it's been a long time, pero really, not in a bad way, just porque it's been very comfortable in a good way.
That's good.
So, yeah. So, pero sí, it was a funny story. Everybody, I was going to put it one time on like when I created my wedding website, I was gonna put it on my wedding website, and Morgan McGee me dijo, Diana, absolutely, because it's about our story. She's like, you can skip that part. People are gonna think that you're a homewrecker. Fine, I'll skip it, but it's the truth. Like, I didn't know. I mean, it wasn't my
lo que está para ti nadie te lo quita. Like in ese momento when you guys met, it was only like people at a party.
Yes.
And then, you know, after he got divorced. Resulta yes. que you guys shared a friend and se right. volvieron a ver y ahí yeah. was completely divorced y ya it was fair game y tú estabas yeah. super single. So.
And it was time. So it was the perfect timing at that point. And por eso la gente dice siempre, deja espera a ver qué pasa porque maybe it's not the right timing right now, but you never know what life. Y de verdad, cuando yo me despedí de él ese día, oh, chao, like, I didn't give him one more thought about this man.
Yeah.
Él se fue por su lado, yo por el mío, I didn't hear anything else until cuando se divorció, that was what, cuando se divorció, mi amiga me dijo, oye, ¿te acuerdas del amigo mío que no sé qué que conociste? Y yo le dije, sí, marica, se divorció. Ah, that was it. Pero,
and then se conocieron, and then the rest is history.
The rest is history.
Yeah. Which very is true.
Yeah.
Ahora, ¿por qué te dicen Pia?
Oh, it's a funny story. So, me dicen Pia porque where my grandparents lived, so my mom and my dad lived with my grandparents for while I was a baby still. I think they might have been a year when they moved out.
I think so.
So, they lived in my grandparents' house for a little bit. And then neighbors, my grandparents have una pareja que también tenía tres mujeres and they
tres
hijas and they all had kids around the same age. So my mom had like her village. She had friends that were mommy friends and they all were having babies at the same time and everybody was like, so this little girl who is, I've known her like we've known them our whole lives. They're casi que ya como que familia at this point. So she's a little older than I am. Y ella le decían, oh, mira, ven para que saludes. Go say hi to Diana Sofia, because my whole name is Diana Sofia. And she's like, Pia, Pia, because she was starting to learn how to talk. And she would say, Pia, 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 Pia. And then I ended up saying, Pia, Pia, and then Pia. So in my family and my best friend, like so many people know me as Pia. And a lot of the times I wear my initials and I'll sometimes do a D, pero sometimes I'll do a P. And people are like, P, like especially people that don't know me, like work with me or something, like they don't know the backstory. They're like a P. And I'm like, oh, you know, that's my nickname. It's Pia. Like, you know, I have to go through the whole spiel. Pero so, yes. Everybody calls me Pia because of her. So La Mona Puche was the one that said, Diana Sofia, Pia Pia, y Pia Pia, Pia Pia, Pia Pia, y me quedé Pia Pia, y to this day, Pia Pia.
I feel que tu nickname es como el nickname de nena. Like,
sí.
Tú te quedaste Pia y nena se quedó nena. Like, literalmente nena. En el colegio le dicen nena, y como que uh-huh. tú eras Pia everywhere. Like, es ahora de adulta, like, I feel que cuando fuiste a la universidad, creo, y como que en el trabajo y eso, que en la universidad la gente que became close to you, como que eventualmente te empezaban a decir Pia.
Sí, Pia. Uh-huh.
Y como que mis hijos le dicen a mi hermana, tía Pia.
Tía.
O sea, como que...
Sí, sí, tía Pia. Todo el mundo me dice Pia. Yeah. Todo el mundo me dice Pia. Pia, Pia. O sea, yo soy Pia. En mi casa soy Pia.
Yeah.
Todo el mundo. Eso
va a ser very interesting. Yeah. Ok. So... Ya hemos cubierto. Pia is the older sister.
Oh, sí.
She embodies the personalidad de un big sister.
Yes.
En nuestra familia, yo soy la hermana de la mitad. I'm super yes. middle child syndrome, pero también I have a little bit of the baby yeah. vibes, porque yeah. mi hermanito, que es el hermanito menor de nosotras, yo le llevo como 10 años. So I was the baby little sister por un montón de tiempo. Entonces, yes. como que yo tengo la personalidad de un middle child, pero también tengo cosas de un little, de la chiquita de la familia.
Yes.
Pia es un Enneagram 1. Yo soy yes. un Enneagram 8.
Yes, I remember that. Yes.
Pia likes hot coffee. Yo nada más tomo iced coffee.
Iced coffee.
Unless it's un café con leche. Y puede ser 10 grados y... Iced coffee.
No.
Pia crunchy granola.
Super full. Crunchy granola. I try.
Y yo soy super, like, conveniencia y, like, no sé, like, super not crunchy at all. pero vamos a ir, let's go through, like, who's most likely to.
Yes.
Okay, who's most likely to become a vegetarian?
Me.
At this point in your life, yeah, you're yes. super crunchy. Okay. Super. Who is more likely to finish eating first?
Ooh, that's a good one.
I feel that yo como super lento.
Sí, tú comes lento. Yes, probably me. Again, I'm a foodie.
Who's most likely to take forever to make a decision?
Tú.
Yeah.
to find out if you should make the decision. And still I'll call you later. Make,
To make, you know. Okay, esta es difícil. Who's most likely to eavesdrop on a conversation?
Oh, that is like the two of us. Eso no tiene.
But we'll be like, tú oyes.
Yes.
I love, like, people watching in restaurantes.
It's super charity. There's always somebody having a fight.
100%.
Always breaking up with someone.
Who's most likely to stop the car on the road trip to go pee?
Tú.
Me, because I drink so much water.
Sí, I feel like you have a very small bladder.
I también.
Like, como mi papá. Like, mi papá no salió de la casa y ya se está orinando.
Sí,
I cannot.
That one would be me.
Yes.
Okay. Who's most likely to get the whole family in trouble? Depends.
That's a good one. The whole family in trouble.
Yeah. Depends.
Porque
cuando se venga Pia también es peliona. Pero yo también a veces soy peliona.
Exacto.
So we don't know.
Pero it's a toss-up. Eso depende. Yeah.
Who's most likely to climb a mountain?
Me.
Super. Like, why am I climbing a mountain? What, like, what? No.
Yes.
It's dirt. Like, no. Definitely Pia.
Yes.
Who's most likely to get sick?
You.
I have the worst immune system.
The worst immune system in the world. La miras y le das gripa.
Yes. Y tú sabes que se me ha mejorado mucho eso. I was, pero in the last 2 years, like, I feel that my immune system has built up.
Sí.
And I have a theory about it, pero bueno.
Yes, me too.
Who's most likely to have 10 dirty cups in their room?
Tú.
Me. They're probably, yeah. No, lo que tengo son, ahora mismo on my nightstand tengo 4 bottles of water que están vacías y una yeah. que está a mitad because fue lo que he estado tomando throughout the day o anoche, no me acuerdo, so sí. Yes, me.
Yeah, not me. I am extremely OCD.
Oh, this is a good one. Who's most likely to talk someone's ear off? You, 100%.
Probably me, sí.
100%.
Porque tú cuando alguien, I would talk to just about anything and anybody. Pero tú, everywhere. Cuando you're not feeling it, tú ya, you like,
Sí, it takes a while for me to, like, get there.
Sí, open up, yes.
Ajá,
get
ajá,
there.
Ajá, ajá, ajá.
Yes. These are good.
I know. Who's most likely to be late?
You.
I've gotten really good. I've gotten better. Pero
actually,
before...
I've gotten better, actually. Pero yo sí hacía, tú sabes lo que hacía yo, you remember this. Cuando tú me, cuando yo te decía, ya estoy saliendo, I was literally getting like in the bathroom.
Oh my God, it drive me insane. Like insane.
I used to see that all the time. Ya estoy saliendo, but I was like literally en el baño bañando.
No, ya, y ya yo sabía. Y ya yo sabía y me daba rabia, which is weird, porque yo también siempre estaba tarde a todas partes.
Tú siempre tarde, y ahora, yes.
I got it really better. Yo yes. era horrible. Like,
ahora
qué
estamos,
pena.
Sí, ahora estamos un poquito más, ya, porque ya entendemos, ya somos mayores.
Yeah, my prefrontal cortex creció.
Yeah, yeah, sí, sí, sí.
You know, después de los 25, it grew and matured.
Yes.
And now yeah, I'm not late. And now I strive a lot to not be late porque I feel que time is such a valuable resource that
sí.
you can never get back. Like, si tú pierdes dinero, you can always make it back. You can always,
sí.
you know,
pero time you can't.
Make more money, but you can
yes.
never make time back.
Yes.
And I feel que as long, I like to tell people como que voy a estar tarde, como que para que
yes.
la persona sepa que su tiempo es valuable, porque en verdad, it's something, it's a, if you really, ahora que estoy de adulta, you really think about it, it's a, you can never get it back.
Never.
Like, you know what I mean? So a mí me parece eso, like
sí.
something really, ya no... I try not to be late. I do a lot of math. If I have to be there at 10,
sí,
I have to find my house by 10. Y me tengo que maquillar, peinar, bla, 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 y empiezo a hacer todo el backward math.
Countdown backwards, como me dices a mí. Cuando le digo, ¿cuánto me toca? ¿A qué hora tengo que salir si mi vuelo es hasta la hora? Me dice, empieza a contar backwards.
Exacto.
So.
Okay, who's most likely to be up first on Christmas morning? I think both of us nos despertamos temprano.
Yeah, nosotros somos mañaneras temprano. Yeah, both of us.
Who's most likely to slam the door when mad?
Tú, probably. Mm-hmm.
Me, but Pia will keep a grudge forever.
Yes, I will keep it for a while. For a while. Until I forget about it, porque it's usually because I forgot about it.
Who's most likely to work for the CIA?
Ooh. I feel que tú me estás ganando in this area. You think things que yo, I had not thought about before. I do have a good way of like investigando people. If I'm
yeah.
really interested, I will. Pero you have a different set of skills que I am very surprised by. The things that you find. So,
yeah. I feel that I'm really good at finding things.
Yes,
and like
you are.
Going down rabbit holes that serve
yes.
good purposes or like...
And you
como,
find like los Easter eggs that no one
ajá,
found.
Lo con, las conexiones. Like I'm really good at connecting.
Yes, you're good at that. Pero sí, no sé. I feel like I would probably get... I would be good at like getting people information. Getting information from people.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
That's,
I saw we could both work there, en verdad.
Yes, en verdad, sí. Both of them. Could be it.
Who's most likely to become a comedian? I don't think either of us.
No.
No, at all.
No.
Who's most likely to win a Grammy? Ninguna. La
no.
que nadie puede cantar.
Aquí tenemos, o sea... Marica,
this is a good one. Who's most likely to forget someone's birthday?
Oh, me. Se me olvidó de Bowie.
No lo llamaste.
No lo llamé.
A mí se me, like, you know... Mi papá estaba aquí, so no se me olvidó.
Bueno, está bien. A mí
pero
se me olvidó.
I feel like you're really good with names and faces.
Sí, I'm good with names and faces, and I try to put... Lately, it's because I feel like I have a lot of information in my brain. I don't know how to get rid of it. of not get rid of it, but I have a lot of information in my brain that it's useless sometimes, and I don't feel like I'm as sharp as I used to, pero creo que porque I'm having... And I don't know if it's the amount of information that I'm getting. And
like
I'm trying to process them from like, you know, like you always think about it. I need to practice mindful silence. Porque I'm getting information while I'm walking, porque estoy en el podcast, en el Audible, en el estoy viendo televisión, tengo live aprendido, tengo música, then I go into meetings, tras meetings, after a meeting I'll grab the phone and talk to somebody porque alguien me llamó. So I feel like all of that input of information, my brain is trying to process, so me está olvidando el cumpleaños, las cosas. So I need to practice mindful silence, is what I heard.
Oh, interesting.
So voy a dejar el teléfono. Ahora que voy a salir a caminar al perro de ahora en adelante, I'm going to leave my phone in the house y no salir con nada. Just walk.
Pero isn't that the time that you call me?
Yes, pero now I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm going to practice mindful silence. I need to practice mindful silence.
Practice mindful silence at night, girl?
At night. Mi marido llega a ver, what are you doing? ¿Qué estás
viendo?
Ay,
lo que yo hago. Yo me levanto a las... between 4:45 and 5 in the morning.
Ajá, para poder ver.
Para poder tener paz. Y yo me levanto y lo primero que hago es rezo.
Okay.
And I visualize things that I'm trying to accomplish. Like, okay. La visualizo. Es casi como manifestarlo, pero bien visualizada, practicada. I heard it in a podcast and I read about it, about visualizar lo que uno quiere, pero como que sentirlo dentro de ti. Like, si quieres, you know, si if you're going to work out that day, like, verte a ti misma working out, sintiéndolo en las piernas, right. Sintiéndolo en tu, like, dependiendo de lo que, por ejemplo, si ese día tengo, en mi persona, si ese día tengo... que hacer este podcast, me visualizo haciendo lo que voy a decir, lo que voy a hacer, yo no sé qué, and it really helps me, like, feel very grounded cuando actually I go ahead and do that. So, eso es lo que yo hago en las mañanas, and then, after doing that, then I grab my phone. I like to give it, like, 30 minutes de no tocar mi teléfono, but then I grab my phone, leo la Biblia for the morning, and then... I catch up on emails, I catch up on like el tiempo de cositas que puedo hacer before the kids wake up, and I feel
maybe
that
ever since I need to do that, pero probably my first thing apenas me levanto es agarrar el teléfono.
And that's so bad for your mental health.
It is. And that's why I'm saying I need to refocus. Mindful silence. That's what I'm going to do in the morning.
Pero overall, I think las dos, I'm really bad at remembering names and faces, but because mm-hmm. I feel that I'm always blissfully unaware of life.
Yes.
Yo vivo en la luna 95% of the time.
Yes.
And y no es por ser grosera. Like, I remember
I
when
feel
I was
like
younger.
Tú tampoco ves bien.
Yo no veo bien, empezando por ahí. Yo tengo astigmatismo, so yo no veo bien de lejos.
Yes.
And, like, en verdad... me pasa con gente que amo y adoro. O sea, hay gente que... yo me acuerdo, when I was younger, I didn't have a system down. Y se me olvidaba la gente, los nombres, y, you know, yo vivo en la luna y pensando y en mi creatividad. And I learned really quickly to always have somebody around me que, like, me ayude.
Ayude.
Ajá. And I adopted this thing that... I'd rather be overly kind than standoffish, porque yo soy bien standoffish por lo general, pero me he dado cuenta que si alguien me saluda o algo así, yo saludo como si tú fueras mi mejor amiga, hola, and then I start doing the mental math back, como que de dónde conozco a esa persona, dónde conozco a esa persona, y como que empiezo a tratar, y entonces eventualmente, pum, lo conecto, pero I'd rather be overly... like,
nice.
Que digan como que ella, sí, porque sí, me saludó sí. Tan nice, a que digan, uy, qué pesada, because before sí. I would be más como que, bueno, no estoy segura quién es y no quiero como que caer.
No sé si la conozco, sí.
And my thing was, no quiero que piensen que soy como que super aggressive with my hugs and my this, pero ahora de adulta siento que I'd rather quedar como, she's, like, overly, like, enthusiastic about saying hi to me than the other way around.
That's a good tactic.
Yes. And I saw, where did I see it? Oh, I saw Kathy Hilton when I was watching Paris in Love. Ella nunca dice, I caught on, que ella nunca dice, it's nice to meet you.
¿Qué dice entonces?
It's great seeing you.
Oh, I like that.
I don't know why I picked it up. I guess because I'm super hyper aware. You know, porque en verdad yo when I was younger, pasé penas que una vez una persona me dijo como que, it's like the fourth time que me dices nice to meet you, and like, era, yo me acuerdo, era como que un super amigo de mi mejor amiga, so era una persona que was, he's like, te voy a parar de saludar. Y me dio, me, o sea, yo quería que me tragara la tierra. Me tragara la tierra. Me tra, o sea, tú no entiendes, yo no sabía dónde meterme. pero me di cuenta, so, I'm so hyper aware of this, que me di cuenta en Paris in Love, que Kathy Hilton nunca dice, it's nice to meet you, it's great seeing you, it's like, no dice nice to meet you, and it's, I feel it's because of that, porque ella es bien como,
ella es spacey, yes.
Ajá, y yo también, yes, soy así, entonces como para no correr el riesgo de quedar mal, ella simplemente dice, oh, it's great seeing you.
Y porque sabe, ella probably meets 20,000 people.
A million, yes, people, so if it works, yes, for Kathy Hilton, yo lo he empezado a aplicar también, it works for me también.
We shall see.
A ver, who's most likely to get into a fight on the internet?
Oh, so me, probably. I am very passionate, and I am an Enneagram 1. So Enneagram 1s are like, what's right, it's right, what's wrong, it's wrong. So yo soy, I might be that person that might, if, like, I could technically, I could get into arguments with somebody. What I decided to do is unfollow them or mute them.
Okay, okay, I'm into, yes, that.
Yes, because, yeah, porque obviously I'm not going to be a troll online.
Oh, but obvio.
Pero yes, yo, pero again, yo soy un Enneagram 1. That's my thing. It has to be right, or there's a right and wrong in my universe. There's a right and wrong. Y yo, if you're on the wrong side of what I consider is wrong, I, yo, you know, I'll get heated. So activated. Don't activate me.
Activated. If you know, you know, that's a Summer House reference. Eso siempre, I think it would be you. I think que yo vivo tan en la luna que a lo mejor no me doy cuenta que somebody's trying to, like, pick a fight with me or something like that. So, I don't know. No, no. Yeah, it's true. A ver. Who's most likely to lock their keys in the car? Bueno, eso ya no pasa. Pero for sure me. Who's most likely to have a weird phobia?
You.
Yeah. A mí me da miedo ciertas cositas that are weird.
Sí, que are weird.
Yeah,
yes,
that is true. Ooh, who's most likely to answer the phone on the first ring?
Me. Let's be real. 100%.
I keep my phone on do not disturb, literal, and on silent. Like, calls do not come in. They go to voicemail. Bye.
I also have a thing with notifications. Que I am, again, I'm an Enneagram 1, so I have to do the right thing. And if somebody calls me, I have to return their call. Or I have to text them and let them know why I didn't pick up the phone. When people should assume I'm busy. Cuando I don't pick up the phone, people assume, okay, she's busy. You know?
Listen, I have 84 unread text messages.
No, absolutely not.
I have, on this computer, I have more on my phone. 35,000 unread emails.
No.
And I keep my phone under not disturbed. I am not, if they tell you, call somebody or, and you will win $1,000,000, do not call me. You, no, will, no, like, no, you will not win that $1,000,000. You, no, call me.
I will pick up the phone. I will pick up the phone. If it's not a spam, and sometimes I'll pick the spam just to play around and see, like, quiere. Because sometimes you just want, you're just activated for no reason and you just want to, like, yell at somebody. It's always, like, fun to yell at these people that try to call you to tell you something. Like, where did you get my phone number from? Why are you calling me?
Why are you calling me? Oh. Let's see. Who's most likely to binge watch an entire show in a day?
You.
100%. Fíjate, viste esto. Me lo estoy viendo, pero yo no sé qué. Bro, just watch it. 2 seconds.
Es que tú no sabes cuando yo estoy watching, cuando yo estoy, cuando yo me, when I lay myself in bed, that's it. I apago, yo pongo, por lo general, it was Friends. And now it's been Big Bang Theory. Pero ya, se pone ahí and I just go to bed.
Oh my God, I can't. Who's most likely to live to 100?
Me.
She's a crunchy granola biohacking her life. Drinking a million supplements.
Million supplements, which, by the way, I just downloaded this Audible book. Se llama Metabolical. Okay. And it talks about the foods that are poisoning us. So I'm, like, in this journey of, like, non-processed.
Here we go again.
Non-processed foods.
Here we go again.
So the saying is, eat foods that protect your liver and feed your gut.
I wish you the best of luck in that journey.
His journey's gonna be great. I literally, yo hice un whole haul of my makeup. My makeup tends to be all clean makeup. Same thing with my skincare. It tends to be all like clean skincare. Okay, I try to keep it as clean as possible. We'll see. I always buy organic fruits porque it has less pesticides. So I'll try.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that esa cosa sí. Pero te acuerdas when you wanted, you went crazy and animal product is completely out.
Animal product is bad for you. It's just that it's, you know.
I'm like, vamos a ver cuánto le dura.
No, me duró mucho porque I was by myself in this island. No one supported me.
Okay, who's most likely to cry at a romantic movie?
You.
I cry for everything.
Yes.
I have specific movies that I watch if I want to cry, like Frozen 2.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you want to cry? No.
Okay, who's most likely to move back with their parents?
Oh.
I feel that I thought that I would never want to move back with my parents. But then cuando fuimos para allá a visitarlos en Kansas, that it was only the siblings. Que fuimos sin esposo, sin hijo, sin nada. It was the core five of us.
It was so cool.
I feel that I would, I'm, you know, why not? Like, me va a cocinar delicioso. Like,
I mean, legit.
You don't have to buy toilet paper. Like, you live your best life.
La única razón por la cual I wouldn't do it is because, again, I am cuckoo loco for Coco, and the situation in su nevera, I cannot. She has every condiment known to mankind. Y todos están abiertos. There's not one that you're like, y entonces, además de eso, in her condiment drawer, tiene un montón de condiments. Like this, claro, she cooks a lot. She cooks all day, every day. Ella cocina delicioso.
Te voy a decir que estás hablando mal de ella.
Pero ella tiene sal, salecita, salezón. The sal del Himalaya, la sal del Parque Washington, la sal de, I mean, de sales, pimientas, mostaza, mayonesa, like, pancito, panzón. Rosquita, la rosquita, la galletica, tiene galleticas para todos. She has cookies for everything.
Yeah, every little, like, no todos los cookies are the same.
And are the same.
Si estás sirviendo esto, es este cookie.
Entonces, you're like, oh, tengo este pancito. Oh, I have this apple butter. You're like, what the hell did you just
say? Yeah, I have this jam. Con este pan, va este jam.
And she has her, like, her fridge is that stocked. There's two of them. Two of them. It's more stocked que la mía. Además de eso, she has a, like, a downstairs freezer que también está fully stocked.
Yes. You will never go, like,
no,
nunca te
vas a
morir de hambre.
Nunca. Jamás.
No. Okay, who's most likely to be on a reality show?
Oh, probably you.
Me? I'm a little bit boring. But, I feel like... Well, yeah.
I mean, I feel like my family could be a reality show. Yo tengo 2 25-year-olds que son locos, so maybe.
Yeah. I feel that it could be like both of us together, como hermanas. Like, I feel that our family but dynamic would definitely se presta para un reality. Yeah. Lo que no vivimos todos juntos, pero yes. I feel que se presta full porque mi papá has, we all have very, like, nuestras personalidades son muy marcadas.
Full.
Y super diferentes.
Super.
And everybody is very, tiene opiniones full, like,
grandes.
Grandes. Pero no sé, nos complementamos, no, like, so yes, it would only be if we would be together. Who would survive a zombie apocalypse? You, 100%. I would die. A mí me agarran y me comen a los dos minutos porque esto me perdí. Lo más seguro, I got lost. Because we won't have any GPS, I'll get lost. Y ya, hasta ahí llego. And I'll be crying in a corner.
In a corner.
Yeah, I will be like running, freaking like MacGyvering things.
Resourcefulness.
100%, 100%, 100%. Who's most likely to live in a haunted house?
No. Neither one of us would survive this.
I would cry and you would be like, absolutely not.
No, I would not. Eso me da muchísima, like, I cannot. Yo,
yeah.
Le tengo miedo, is that.
Yeah, no, eso me da creepiness.
Yes.
Who's most likely to laugh during a serious moment?
Me. Both of us.
I think of both of us. Pero tú, like, and if we're together, oh my God.
Oh, super. Yes.
Remember when we were younger, que de repente nos entraban ganas de reírnos, and it would make my mom so upset.
And like she would nos regañaba because we were happy.
But it was usualmente when she was like flustered. Stressed out.
It was whenever she was stressed out and flustered, and then we would start like laughing nonstop, and she would hate it.
She would be so upset. Que we can't stop laughing. What are we supposed
pero
to do?
But you know where we get that from? My dad. My dad, cuando mi mamá está flustered, he laughs, and then he'll be like, voy a decir algo. And then he'll like poke the bear a little bit, y se ríe. We get that from him. It's like a little sick.
I know. But that's a good thing, I think.
Yes, I think so too.
Who's most likely to scream when they see a spider?
Probably you, más escandalosa que yo, pero I hate spiders también.
My God, remember when we found that spider in my mom's basement?
Oh my God.
It is spooky. I wanted to die.
It was like, so big.
Burn the freaking house. That's and call it a day.
You know, es que yo no soy de bugs, ni de nada de eso.
No, nada de eso. Eso no son los vibes de nadie. Who is most likely to take a secret to the grave? I mean, it depends because I would probably tell my sister and she will keep the secret, but or she will tell me and I will keep the secret. Like, I feel que eventually, yeah.
If I do keep the secret to the grave, porque se me olvido.
También.
but for the most part, I'll keep a secret if it's something that's like, hey, somebody, pero si alguien me dice, no le voy a decir a nadie, pero eventualmente va a salir a relucir, como que alguien que dice, no le voy a decir a nadie, pero voy a que estoy embarazada. Ay, somebody's gonna find out. Like, okay, I get that. Eso es un secret.
Me llama a mí, me dice, ¿tú sabes quién? No sé quién cita. Está embarazada.
Pero overall, como que no, pero si es un secret, como que una cosa muy fuerte, obviamente I'm gonna keep it.
Claro. Pero, I probably won't keep it 100% because I'll probably tell you.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that's true.
I would be more likely to spill the beans.
Yes.
Ooh. Who's most likely to get away with murder?
Oh. I want to say me. Let me tell you why. This is my theory. People think that I'm super, like, sweet and nice. And I am very sweet, and that's how I live my life. I am kind, I am sweet, I am nice, pero I have a side of me que
Pia would do bullying on me when I was little. La gente me pregunta que por qué yo tengo como una personalidad tan fuerte. Te presento a mi hermana que me hizo bullying, o sea, literal.
Pero, tú sabes que my son softened me, for sure. Carlos Alberto softened me. When he was born, I was softened. Pero I was, sí, yo, sí.
Pia me hacía un bullying tremendo. I feel que también como que tú eres más racional y más como que you tend to be a logical person, your Enneagram 1 es bien así. Sí. Whereas si yo, if I commit murder, I'll probably start crying and get anxiety and I'm 100% telling my sister.
Exactly. Like I would be like, okay, what are we going to do? Where are we going to hide it? Like very like compartmentalized. Yes, racionalizando los sentimientos. That's very
simple. Exactamente. Who's most likely to talk their way out of a speeding ticket?
You probably.
Yeah. 100% yes. I think so también. I've gotten out of a couple of them, yes. When I was younger.
Yeah. I've never gotten any ticket. Yo nunca. I've never been able to
speed. Yeah, desde que I had my son, I've never gotten a ticket. But when I was younger, I would. Porque, again, vivo en la luna. So, entonces, como que algo cruzaba por donde no era, like, no veía las cosas. And it was like, yeah, no. Pero no.
Yes.
Vamos a hacer two more y ya.
Okay. Algo está roncando full.
Oh, who's most likely to secretly be a vampire?
Oh, I love this question.
You?
Me? I love this question is what I said.
I know, pero you would be my answer.
Yeah, probably.
I think so, yeah. And this reminds me, hoy, qué risa, my mom is here from Kansas. And mi abuela, who lives in Aventura, mi mamá, like, la trajo a que estuviéramos aquí where I'm at, porque yo estoy más para el sur. And we went to get our hair done. Like, I got my hair done. Y mi abuela se cortó el pelo, whatever. My grandmother's 96.
90. She's going to be 96.
She's
going
to be 96. Y mi abuela está perfecta. Like,
yes.
De la her mente, de todo. Like, obviamente está viejita, so camina despacito. Ella tuvo una fractura en un brazo, so no, en los dos brazos, so tiene la movilidad, no la tiene 100%, pero overall for 96, I would say that she's top tier.
Sí.
And la señora de la peluquería were like, my God, no lo puedo creer, míralo bien. And I was like, well, yeah, los nietos tenemos una teoría.
El vampiro.
Que she's a vampire. She's going to outlive all of us.
She's going to outlive all of us.
Yes, and I feel that you would get her vampiro, her vampironess.
Her vampironess. I might.
And then the last one. Oh, this is a good one. Who's most likely to say sorry after a fight?
Mm.
Me. I say sorry for anything, even when it's not my fault.
See, you. In your soft era, see, you. Yes, you. A mí me fue, no, a mí no me molesta decir sorry. Cuando yo estoy en lo mal, I will be the first person to admit I'm wrong. Pero
I'm really good at saying I'm sorry. ¿Tú sabes que en my last relationship me hicieron sentir mal de for saying I'm sorry? Like they you kind of like weaponized my ability to say sorry.
Ah, sí, porque te decían don't say sorry, just don't do it again.
The just don't do something that's gonna piss me off.
Piss me off.
Everything pisses you off.
Sí, exacto.
Pero I think al revés, yo tengo que aprender a stop my therapy. My therapist me dice como que you need to stop saying you're sorry for things that you
didn't, no hiciste nada malo.
Ajá, like why, you're apologizing for what, lady? Like, I don't
yes.
know, but I feel like I need to apologize.
Yes, you know, Dana would apologize for everything. I apologize for things that I do wrong and when I'm out of terms and when I try. But I do try to be very mindful and no hacer cosas that might. I do have that and I do try to live like that. Tratar de hacer cosas, no tratar de hacer cosas que puedan cause hurt to somebody else, but I'm human and I will make mistakes and I will get angry and I will do something. So I do apologize and I will say, you know, I'm sorry, my, and I apologize. I retook it back, but apologizing in a way that says something like, hey, like, apologizing como que, hey, not putting it on the other person. Como que,
yeah.
I'm apologizing, estoy pidiendo perdón, pero you acted this way. No, 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 I'm apologizing for this, this, and that. And me. Don't apologize and blame the other person while you're apologizing for it. I hate
when that is literally not an apology. When you do that, it's called gaslighting. Yeah, yeah. I feel that I'm really good at apologizing. I don't, no es que yo haga mil mistakes, pero again, yo soy super despistada. So hay veces que como que, ay, me trajiste esto. Oh my God, se me olvidó. Like, yes. Cosas así. But cuando estoy mal, sí, como que si tuve como un dispute con alguien, I think esto lo aprendimos de mi papá, creo. I feel que esto lo aprendimos con el matrimonio de mis papás, where they're very good at repairing.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Y no es que mis papás vivían peleando ni nada, pero mis papás, we saw a good, muy buen example of repairs.
Yes.
And saying sorry, things like that. So yo siento que eso es super natural, como que I'm able to be like, oh, you know, I was out of pocket. I said something como que whatever.
Yes.
Y como que, oh, I didn't hurt your feelings, or if I hurt your feelings, like, tú sabes como, you know. Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Pero bueno, I feel that we covered a lot. I feel that we covered things, fun things.
Jack, what else? A poquito más. And
we talked about a lot of fun stuff.
Yes.
I think that this answers a lot of questions. De quiénes somos y no sé qué.
Where we come from. Sí, de dónde somos. Pero no que nosotros somos born and raised barranquilleras. We fell in love. Puerto Rico.
Our second home is Puerto Rico.
Our second home is Puerto Rico. And then, pero ya somos gringos, be gringoing.
Yeah, I mean, yo vivo en Miami, no es muy gringo, bitch.
Tú eres miamense by heart, y yo, pues, I'm like the whitest, brownest chick you'll ever find.
I know, te iba a decir, hablando de como que where we're from, it's funny because Pia moved to the United States, y estaba mayor que yo.
Sí, 18.
Pero Pia habla mejor inglés que yo, because yo... I think a lot en español.
Juliana me dijo que I laugh en español. Me dice que te oigo hablando en inglés. Like, I hear you and you're in English, blah, 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 blah. And then I hear you laughing. She's like, you laugh in Spanish.
What does that even mean?
And I was like, con jota.
Do we both reírnos en español?
Maybe. I have to now pay attention to people that are bilingual. How do they laugh? Whether or not they laugh in English or Spanish. That would be interesting.
That's super interesting.
Lo voy a hacer. I'm going to do it con Carlos Alberto, porque Carlos Alberto is very bilingual. I'm going to try this.
Para que el test funcione, hay que hacer una persona super gringa que no sepa español. Una yes. persona que no hable inglés, o como que mi mamá, que no, el inglés de ella no es. And then... Like, alguien que sea bilingüe, pero que sea más, like, y ver like, how it...
The tears of how everybody laughs.
Yeah.
This is a good survey. We need to do a focus group on this.
I know, I feel that we do. Yes. Yo no sé, Diana dijo el otro día en nuestro último podcast que ella no sabe llorar en español, and I really, en inglés, sorry.
I know, I love that, sí.
Y es verdad, yo no sé llorar en inglés, así como yo no sé rezar en inglés. Like, yo siento que yo... Dios no me entiende si yo no le hablo español.
Okay.
Like, no me va a entender, no nos vamos a entender.
Okay.
I feel que nada más habla español, which is not true, obviamente. Pero I feel que si yo no rezo en español, como que no puedo. Y después me puse a pensar, en verdad, yo lloro en español también. Como que mi mente, sí, la emoción que está sintiendo, la procesa en español. Español.
Sí, maybe también. That might be true. Yo casi no lloro, pero sí, that might be true.
Oh, that's a good one, ¿verdad? Bueno, we answered who would cry, pero we didn't talk about the fact que ella no llora.
No, yo sí lloro, pero not as often as some people. Not as often. Yo sí lloro, I do cry, pero, you know, I'm not like... ¿Sabes qué me hace llorar mucho? When I'm angry. If I'm angry, I do cry out of anger.
That makes sense.
Angriness makes me cry. Y frustration, if I'm frustrated, porque yo soy, again, I'm an Enneagram 1 to the T. If yo estoy frustrated with something that no me está saliendo bien, I will cry. I would cry.
I cry because of everything. Porque vi un perrito, porque pensé en algo que pasó, porque vi un movie, but I cry for everything.
Yeah.
Pero this was fun. I hope that let us know. If you have any other questions for
us. Any other questions for us? ¿Qué más quieren saber de mi chica?
Yes, ¿qué más quieren saber de nosotras y de nuestra vida? And we're planning another podcast with Pia's best friend.
Yes.
That is also going to be super fun, so we can't wait to share that with you.
Yes.
Bueno.
It's hilarious también. Ella también habla el inglés medio María Conchita Alonso.
Yes, ella y yo somos same con eso.
Same.
Bueno, las quiero.
Bye.